Maybe he's remote controlled, and I don't know. He's so stupid. It doesn't make any sense. But now it was Dr. Wily all along. So now we gotta take care of this glaring loophole, glaring plot hole. Because it was all a hostage situation. Kosag's daughter was kidnapped by Wily, and Proto Man went and got Kalinka back, brought her back to Kosag, and now everything's happy. Everything, all is forgiven. All the crimes you committed against humanity, it's fine. As long as you didn't mean it, you know. And so now I gotta fight Wily, which apparently Proto Man had enough initiative to go sneak into Wily's lair, I guess, and, you know, capture Kalinka, but not enough initiative to actually, you know, destroy any of these obstacles or destroy his lab like I do every fucking couple of months, or even apprehend Wily. He's just like, hey, bro, I heard you got that fucking hostage girl. And I'm totally going to take it. What are you going to do about it? And he's like, well, I guess nothing. I guess we have to advance the plot. Really, all it did, it accomplished nothing. It moved forward the plot by unveiling that Wily was behind it. And Mega Man gets to not kill somebody. So, his conscience is spared. But as we've gone over with Mega Man X, you know, they deliberately built Mega Man X with conscience. So he has emotions, he feels things, he makes his own decisions, he has free will. Which is to say that it implies that Mega Man has no free will. He doesn't have the same decisions. So what is he? What's going on? It's a story behind those eyes. Are you a real boy or not? No one knows. I don't even think anyone cares, really. I know I don't care anymore. Well, I really care. I really care a lot. I want to know the answers that they're not going to tell me, because they haven't made a good fucking Mega Man game except for those two downloadable titles in like 15 fucking years. And then, they fired everybody that likes Mega Man from Capcom. And he won't let anybody else make any Mega Man games. Take a look at this motherfucker. This reminds me of some Resident Evil shit or something. Where, like, they're just creating, like, huge bio-organic weapons. And it's just, they made the med tools, which are, like, giant robots. Oh, I'm totally gonna die, girl. Not in the one line. Now usually when, in most of the games, when you're frozen, you can't pause, you can't even pause the game. Thank God they fixed that, because I was dead. I was stun locked and he was going to hit me more than once. Which would have meant I'm dead. I don't even think I'm using the right move. I remember the last time I fought this guy, he died way faster. I think, I'm supposed to be using probably dust or something. I don't know. But Ring is so effective on everybody, so I pull it out almost routinely. Because it's so goddamn effective. And now we're going on to stage 2. The sequel. Pretty straightforward. This thing kind of love is, like, you look at the maps for all these levels. Like, if you were to chart it out all, like, you can look it up. There's charts for all the levels in Mega Man, right? And you can graph it out and you see what's going on. And if you just follow the path, it's a very straight path. It's usually like a very straight line. I mean, they're all straight lines, obviously, because, you know, it's the NES. They couldn't make curves. They couldn't make curvy stages. Even today, making a curvy stage is kind of, I mean, why would you want to? I could probably get that E-Tank, but I don't need it. I don't want it. I'm not even going to worry about it. Too much hassle for no reward. As it is, I'm probably not going to use all the E-Tanks I have. Got 5. I thought I had more. I'm good. I don't need them. But, what was it? Yeah. So everything is, like, pretty straight. But, like, you know, You expect a... Oh, another E-Tank. I got a freebie. I don't even need it. How about that? Why'd you put that there? Why? Why did you do that? Are you trolling me, Capcom? Is that what you're doing? That's what this whole game feels like. I feel like they're trolling you. It certainly does to me. I feel very offended at the notion. I think they were trolling everybody with fucking Mega Man Legends 3, am I right? So, all the stages, like if you try all the levels, they're all very straight. Hardly any turns whatsoever. But, very few stages in Mega Man history, like all the Mega Mans, put them all together. Very few stages, and frankly, very few instances of the stages themselves are boring or out of place or you know, I don't know, repeated and, you know, ad nauseum and just copy pasta and shit. It's all pretty cool. It's all pretty varied. But they're all straight lines. I mean, we've played some games lately that were all straight lines. And then we complain about them because they're straight lines and they're boring. Make some curves and shit. Well, you don't need curves. You just need to make the straight line really fucking awesome. Like Mega Man does. Like, you can make the entire stage could just be one really long hallway. And just, if there's, like, if every room in that hallway was fucking insane and completely different, then you wouldn't even give a shit. You'd be like, this is totally awesome. So I think this guy is called the Red Devil. Kind of looks like a giant dirt devil. Except he shoots fire and giant medicine balls. I guess. Medicine balls coming out of his forehead and giant fireballs coming out of his face. And once again, the weakness is the giant glowing vagina in the middle of his head. The big green glowing clitoris that you hit with a ring. Just like the first guy with the glowing clitoris in the middle of his face. I'm gonna stop saying clitoris. Because the word is losing all meaning. Why do you have to put a giant fucking W on your fucking castle? Is there any confusion as to whose residence it is? Oh, I don't remember if this is my house. Honey, is our house the one with the giant fucking skull in the front? Or is it the one with the red door? I don't know. Oh wait, there's a W. Her name doesn't start with a W. Look at this! Look at what the fuck? What am I supposed to do? Even reasonably, you can't expect me to expect that. Unbelievable. Now I'm gonna make sure I got my drills recharged, because as I mentioned before, they're very important. I'm gonna need them, and you're gonna find out why. Because one of the things I hate is the final boss fight in this game, and one of the reasons why I hate it is because they made it the most retarded way of damaging him that I've ever seen. Like, I didn't even know how it fucking worked. I had to fucking look this shit up on the internet, I think. I think I figured it out when I was a kid, but I forgot. I had to look it up again on the internet. Yay, boss rush time. We all know what's going on. We're almost at the end of the game. So this guy is gonna die to some dive missiles. And here's the problem. Like, you see me do all the boss rushes before, and I don't have any problems. I kill the guy, and then I get a health pack, and then I'm fine. And I go kill the next guy and get a health pack, I'm fine. And I don't need any E-Tanks or anything. But when I do the boss rush in this game, it's so aggravating that I end up using a few E-Tanks, probably. So this is probably gonna happen again. But it's okay, because I got a fuck ton of E-Tanks. I'm certainly not gonna need him on the final boss, because he's pretty easy. One more line. See what happens. There you go. Take a look at my man. Getting the fuck out of there. Ah, hate this guy. I hate him so much, girl. Yeah. to hit. Ah, that was stupid on my part. Seriously, if this guy hits you with his face and he didn't freeze you in place, then you're just asking for trouble. That's all you're doing. What is he doing? He froze me in place twice in a row. I was like, oh, you're not frozen enough. I gotta double freeze your ass. I'm gonna make sure you never come out of this coma. Pull out my dust crusher. It's a dirt bomb, that's what it is. It's a dirt bomb. Totally not to be confused with the soak bomb that you get in Mega Man X 2, which is exactly the same. Actually, you know what? I've said that, like that was, it's the Gray Palette Swap Mega Man. And I love the Gray Palette Swap Mega Man, but every move that you get with the Gray Palette Swap Mega Man sucks ass. But the Dust Crusher, pretty good fucking move. I'll say that. That's like the one move with the Gray Palette Swap that's really awesome. So I'm about to kill this guy. Yeah, there you go. Now we're halfway done. Toadman. Like, he doesn't even start to fight, like, ready. He's just sitting there like, what are you gonna do? He doesn't even want to fight you. Because he knows he's gonna get his ass kicked. At least he's changing it up. He's jumping around, trying to attack with you. But he's easy to dodge, because he's a frog. Frogs aren't particularly fast. But he's not of their own accord. I get exhausted every time I look at Dust Man. I mean, not only is it depressing that I'm fighting a fucking vacuum cleaner with a gun, but, he's got invincibility moves, and I hate invincibility moves. No one has ever seen an enemy with an invincibility move and gone, you know what? This is more exciting. I like it this way. No one's ever said that. No one's ever thought about it. So, I'm gonna change things up, and I'm totally gonna fight this guy mano a mano, plus a bunch of health tanks, because he's gonna kick my ass. The reason being that I'm really gonna need the Feral Blaster for the final boss, and I don't want to use any of it. So, I'm gonna make sure and save all of it, and just shoot him with the regular buster. And he makes me use an E-Tank on his ass, because he's a fucking punk bitch. Look at this. It's so much shit that he's throwing at you. It's ridiculous. Like, you dodge one, you have to dodge it twice. Like, I'm using two E-Tanks on this asshole. Two! There's never been a boss this hard in any Mega Man game ever before or after or before or since. But I have an excess of E-Tanks, so I don't even give a fuck. Let's see what happens to this guy. Yeah. Best move ever. And you think, okay. Oh. How stupid can I be? He's not even moving and I get hit. You think, okay, so this guy's frozen in time. Couldn't you, like, get, like, a critical hit on him or something? Because he's completely, you know, immobile. You could just aim it down his fucking throat and blow his fucking brains out. Robot brains. But no, I don't know. I'm not going to judge. I don't know how fucking Mega Man works. So this is a pretty cool ship. I'm going to pull out my rings and completely blow this bitch. And you're thinking, okay, well, you have to save... You were saying you need to save all those, fucking rockets. Or not the rockets, the drills. And you had to save the pharaohs. But why didn't you have to save all the rings? Well, that's why. Didn't take too long. Even if it did, I don't need him so bad. I could still blast him and he'd be dead. Now, here's the stupidest fucking thing. I didn't know this. And if you didn't fuck around, you probably didn't notice either. when you shoot the drill, if you hit the shoot button again while it's in the air, it'll automatically explode remotely. So, what you need to do is not hit him with the drill, because if you hit him with the drill, it just bounces off pathetically. But you need to make it explode right in front of him so it hits the glowing vagina on the front of his ship. That's the only way you can damage him. How fucking stupid is that? I don't even know. You know what's stupider than that? There's only one thing stupider than that. The final boss, which is the airship that now we've come to know and love as the final boss fight of every Mega Man game since. Every Mega Man to come after this one has had the exact same boss fight. You fight Wily in his little airship. And, just flying around shooting plasma bullets at you. And that's it. End of story. But this one is the first one that you fight him like this. And this one, he can only be damaged by the Pharaoh Shot. So if you run out of Pharaoh Shot when you're fighting this guy, you're screwed. Start the game over. So the trick here is that every time you see a plasma flash, you're gonna know where he is for like half a second. So you have to be in that spot, just arbitrarily in that spot, hope you're there to hit him within that half a second. It helps if you charge it up, because it does a fuck ton of more damage. There we go. The game's over. I beat him. And he falls like 300 feet, but he's alive and begging for mercy. Yay, fanfare. Oh, he got away. What are you doing? Why were you just standing there? And now you're gonna retreat like a bitch. You're not Mega Man, you're Mega Bitch. And there's this fucking spaceship just smoking. He's just smoking a cigar in there like, hey, I'm victorious. In my own head. Whole castle explodes. Oh, there's Mega Man. You saw him teleport away. Explodes in a skull shape. I don't know what kind of bombs you need to plant to have that happen. But I gotta get me some. That's fucking awesome. Wouldn't that be great? Like you always go like to see fireworks shows, like 4th of July, shit like that. And they got the fireworks that explode in certain patterns that are pretty cool. What if they had ones that exploded into skull patterns? I know they could fucking figure that out. NF King. I love NF King. He's the best of all kings. Except when he built this game. This game had good art, I'll say that. I mean, he was an art director. But, it wasn't well designed, I wouldn't say. It's still better than, like, 90% of other games that have ever been made. But, not as good as the 10% that includes all the other Mega Man games. Now I'm riding this train that apparently was not damaged by Wily's, onslaught on the world. What's up with my hair? It's looking all weird. It's clipping in the background. Boy, it's waving around. That's what's happening. Except my sideburns. They're entrenched. Yeah. But he had blue hair in like the opening cutscene. But he also had bronze skin, so I don't know what's going on. There's no coordination going on here with these art people. They're just kind of dicking around back there. This music's kind of weird, because it keeps changing tempo. Oh, there's Roll. Yay, sepia tone. That's how you know it's a happy scene. I think that might have been the first time you actually see Roll, like, in the vaults, I guess, because you can't say flesh. Fuck you, Brightman, I hate you. You're alright, Toadman, but I kind of feel sorry for you. Because you totally suck. You can't fight, like, anything. Why are they demonstrating these guys out of order? They're number 25, they're number 29, and now number 27. Now number 26. What is going on? You couldn't put them in order, man. You put all the other ones in order. This is why this game sucks. This is the number one reason. They put these fuckers out of order. You clearly did not have enough foresight to give a shit to put things in order and make things good. That's why none of you work at Capcom anymore. That's not true, but it could be true. Skullman. I would say Skullman is a pretty badass design, one of the best designs I've ever seen. And you think, okay, like Skullman, after that you just pack it in, because you're not getting any better than Skullman. But it doesn't feel like so out of place. It doesn't feel like they didn't make him like an uber boss or anything like that. It was really cool, it really balanced him out. And his stage was pretty awesome too. Pretty much all the enemies in his stage were unique to his stage. So that's been Mega Man 4. I'm not playing Mega Man 1. I'm never gonna do it. But I played Mega Man 4. And this is the end.